वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू सरस्वती शिशु कुंज. स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू टॉपिक इन अ ग्रामर. दिस टॉपिक वॉज ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन बाय मी ड्यूरिंग लाइव क्लासेस. टुडे इन दिस टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर 18 एडवर्ब्स. एज पर द टाइटल एडवर्ब्स व्हाट डू वी कॉल एडवर्ब्स. So students, if you remember, can you see your verbs? Verbs. Verbs. Okay, as you know, verbs, it shows action. So what do we call an adverb? Adverb means, can you see adverb? Adverbs. So adverb means which adds something more about verb. That is called adverb. Adverb means which does something more, which adds something more about the verb. It is called adverb. So please, dear students, you need to remember what do you call adverb. So please try to remember, adverb is a word which does something more about verb, adjective or another adverb in the sentence. Here we how to learn the meaning of the adverb. So adverb means what we call a word which tells us more about verb, adjective or another adverb. That is called adverb. We will see here through examples. So first I am going to write example. Just check it. I am very happy. First example. Second example.
Happy, that is our
adjective. I am very happy. Okay. So your very, it says more about adjective. Can you see a word which tells us more about verb? Adjective or verb? Adverb. So you are happy. That is adjective. Happy is adjective, and your adverb is very. So your very says more about happy. Very happy. How happy? Very happy. So your adverb, it is a verb which tells something more about verb, adjective or another adverb in the sentence. So your happy is adjective, very is adverb. I hope you got it. Second, C speaks French fluently. So students, can you see it? C speaks French fluently. How C speaks French? So what will you get answer? You will get answer fluently. So your fluently, that is our adverb in the sentence. Remember dear students, how C speaks? Speaks. Okay? This speaks, speaks our verb. Speak, that is our verb, and fluently, that is our adverb. So here you will get answer that C speaks French fluently. Fluently is adverb and speaks verb. So here adverb, it tells more about verb. Okay, fluently. So fluently is adverb. Now listen to my dear students, ly. When you say ly at the end of the verb, ly. This ly, it means suffix. When you say ly at the end of the word, most of the words are called adverb. Most of the adverb, they take ly at the end of the word. So here fluently there is a adverb. I hope you got it. Third one, C says beautifully. Can you see your students? Beautifully. How she sings? So what will you get answer? You will get beautifully. So your beautifully, that is also adverb. That is also adverb. I hope you got it. Next, and here sings. Sings, that is our verb. How she sings? How she sings? So you will easily get answer. Beautifully. Beautifully is adverb. Can you see your adverb? Can you see your adverb? Okay, I hope you got it. They dance very happily. They dance very happily. So students, here in this sentence there are two adverbs. Happy. How happy? So what will you get? Very. Okay. So your very, it says more about happy. Happy is an adverb here. So your very, that is all adverb in the sentence. Okay. So students, here they dance very happily. So my dear students, try to remember adverb means what? Adverb means a word which tells us more about verb, adjective or another adverb. So in the first sentence, I am very happy. So your verb is adverb, happy is adjective. Second sentence, she speaks French fluently. Your speech is verb and fluently is adverb. Okay? Next. Third, she sings beautifully. So your beautifully is adverb and sings is verb. They dance very happily. So very happily. Can you see the two adverb? Happily and very. Can you see another one? Very. So your very, it says about happily. So your very is adverb. So students, I hope you understood. This is the introduction of adverb. Let's go further for the adverb. Okay students, let's see. Students, here adverbs. There are five types of adverbs as we have learnt in live classes. So five kinds of adverb. First adverb, adverb of manner. Second, adverb of place. Third, adverb of time. Fourth, adverb of degree. Adverb of frequency. So students, here what do we call? These are the five types of adverb. So first we are going to learn step by step all the types. First we will learn about adverb of manner. Adverb of manner, it means what? If you ask, Okay, if you want to identify adverb manner, so you need to ask question by how or in what manner. How or in what manner. Okay. Second, adverb place. Adverb place. So your what? Okay, adverb place. It means place. So if you want to get the adverb place, you need to ask question by where. Next, adverb time. It shows time. So you ask question by when. So easily you will get adverb place in the sentence. Adverb of degree. Adverb of degree. So students, if you want to get adverb from the sentence, adverb of degree, you need to ask question. You need to ask question. Okay. So that's what you need to ask question. What? How much? And adverb of frequency. So you need to ask question by how often. If you ask question by these words, easily you will get adverb from the sentences. Okay. I am speaking very fluently. So that is called adverb manner. How I am speaking, in what manner I am speaking. So fluently, that is called adverb of manner. Okay. Next, so students, now step by step, we will see first adverb of manner and second adverb of place. Today in this video, we will learn two adverbs. That is adverb of manner and second is adverb of place. Let's learn the first type of adverb of manner. Yes, students, now let's see adverb of manner. Assume adverb of manner. So what it says? It says how or in what manner the action is done. Okay? So please remember, it shows adverb of manner, it shows how action is done. Adverb of manner, it shows how action is done or in what manner it means. Okay? Please, it answers the questions. Okay? Here, it answers the question in what manner. Okay? Adverb manner. That is. And listen to me, my dear students. Many adverb manner, they end. They end with ly. They end with ly. Okay? Just for example, if I write here, nice, nicely, quick. So students, here quickly. If I write here slow, so slowly. Okay. Next, dear students, another bright. So that is here brightly. Next, careful. So carefully. Students, here most of the adverb of manner, they end with ly. Look at some examples. Nice, quick, slow, bright, careful. These all are adjectives. If you want to make adverb from the adjective, you need to add ly at the end of the adjective. Nice, nicely, quick, quickly, slow, slowly, bright, brightly, careful, careful, beautiful, beautiful. These are the examples of adverb of manner. So students, I hope you got it. Let's see some examples of adverb of manner. Okay? Let's see. I hope you understood this all the things. Adverb of manner, it says how action is done. It answers the question in what manner. They end with ly. Okay? And these are the, some examples of adverb of manner. So now, today we are going to learn alloy forms of the given adjective. Alloy form. Here you can see in the brackets adjectives are given. Angry, sleepy, careful, attentive, sad, slow, loud, happy. So students, we how to add alloy and the end of the adjective. Okay, and we finish. We will finish this exercise. First sentence. The tired old man walked dash to the bus station. The tired old man walked to the bus station. How? You can see. The tired old man walked to the bus station. He was tired, you can see. How he walked to the bus station? Second, the mouse reached for the piece of cheese. Third, the children danced dash. The lady read her book dash. Fifth, the rude man shouted dash at the taxi driver. The tortoise walked dash but steadily towards the finishing line of the race. Seven, I looked at the beggar dash. The lioness roared dash when the man approached her cubs. So students, how we will write? So first you can say the tired old man walked to the bus station. So what is the adverb for this? What will you think, dear students? What will you think? Okay, I hope it will be here. You can see what will be the answer. What do you think? What will be the answer? Okay, so here I think your answer is careful. The tired old man walked carefully to the bus station. Okay. Second, the mouse reached for the piece of cheese. The mouse reached for the piece of cheese. What? The answer is sleepy. So sleepy. Now can you see a why is given? So we need to remove why and we have to put I or why. Listen to me, dear students. When at the end of why, if you want to make adverb, remove Y and just add I am Y at the end of the adjective. If you see Y, so add I am Y for making adjective. Next, so second answer, the mouse reached for the piece of cheese slippery. The children dance, dance. Can you see here? Happy. So it will be happy again, I am Y. The children dance happy. Second, the lady read her book dance. Can you see her attentive? So dear students, your answer will be attentive. She read her book attentive. With attention, you can say attentive means attention. So your answer is attentive. Alva. Fifth, the rude man shouted at the taxi driver. The man was rude. So how he shouted at the taxi driver? What will you say? Will you say angry or loud? Will you say angry or loud? What will you say? The man was rude. So what will you say? Yeah, you can say angry. Angry at the taxi driver. Next. The tortoise walked dash but steadily towards the finishing line of the race. So can you say tortoise? As you know, tortoise slow. So you will write here slowly. The tortoise walked slowly but steadily towards the finishing line of the race. Seven, I looked at the beggar. Now can you see here sad? So it will be here sadly with unhappiness. The lions roared, that's when the man approached her chaos. Okay? The lion roared loud, with a lot of noise. The lion roared loudly when the man approached her cubs. So students, these are the exercises. Sentences. For the first exercise, add only L1. Okay? So you can see here, the tired old man walked carefully to the bus station. The mouse reached for the piece of cheese slippery. The children danced happily. Okay. The lady read her book attentively. The rude man shouted angrily at the taxi driver. The tortoise walked slowly but steadily answers. Okay, to the call. So second type of adverb.
Adverb place.
So what adverb place? It means what?
Where action takes place. So adverb of place, it shows where action takes place.
I have given you two examples. Let's see.
I couldn't find my pen anywhere. I asked the boys to come inside. I couldn't find my pen anywhere.
So what will you say here? Which are the two adverbs?
So can you see here which word shows place?
Anywhere.
So that is an adverb. It shows place.
Adverb.
I asked the boys to come inside.
What I asked?
Where? So you can say inside. It shows place. So adverb.
The word which shows place in the sentence.
Okay. You can say it's an adverb of place. I couldn't find my pen anywhere. So anywhere you can say adverb.
Anywhere, nowhere, somewhere, inside, outside.
I asked the boys to come inside.
Adverb. So these are the examples of adverb of place. And my dear students, remember, adverbs. Adverbs can appear in the beginning, in the middle, or at the end of the sentence. Adverb can appear in the beginning, at the middle, or at the end of the sentence. Sometimes it's better to forgive others. Okay? You can say, sometimes it comes in the beginning. I speak very carefully. So carefully. Very careful at the end of the sentence. Like that, adverb comes. Adverb can appear in the beginning, in the middle, or at the end of the sentence.
Here it is adverb of place where action takes place.
So adverb of place, it shows where action takes place. So students, now here we will go for the one exercise, adverb of place and adverb of manner. Okay? Let's see exercise. Okay students, you can see here five sentences, but what is the instruction?
Underline the adverb in each sentence and name its kind.
So students, here we how to identify the adverb, which is the adverb in the sentence and what kind of adverb it is.
As we know, adverb manner and adverb place.
Okay, we learnt only two types of adverbs in the beginning: adverb manner and adverb place. Okay,
so students, here you can see the hungry child ate the food quickly.
How he ate the food? So what will you get answer?
Quickly.
Students, here quickly is adverb, but what kind of it is?
So students, it's an adverb of manner. The first answer, adverb of manner. The hungry child ate the food quickly, adverb of manner. Second, the teacher taught the class well.
How? Ask question to the sentence. How the teacher taught the class? What will say the answer?
Why?
How the?
So what do you say? Where? So your where, it's an adverb of manner once again.
Okay students, next.
The dog follow its master everywhere.
So students, now ask question to the sentence. Where the dog follow its master? What will you get answer?
Everywhere.
The dog follow its master everywhere.
So yeah, everywhere it's adverb.
But what kind of it is?
Adverb of place.
It's answer adverb of place.
Next, my watch is nowhere to be found.
My watch is nowhere to be found.
Nowhere to be found.
So which word suggests place in the sentence?
So you will get nowhere.
So your nowhere is an adverb of place.
Okay. Next, he searched for his notebook everywhere. Where did he search for his notebook? What? You will get answer. You will get answer everywhere. The word which suggests place, it indicates adverb of place. So yeah, everywhere. So that is your adverb of place. So students, here this is the exercise. You can see on the board. The hungry child ate the food quickly. So adverb of manner. The teacher taught the class well. Adverb of manner. The dog followed its master everywhere. Adverb of place. My watch is nowhere to be found. Adverb of place. He searched for his notebook everywhere. Adverb of place. Students, it's an exercise of adverb of time. Sorry, adverb of place and adverb of manner. Okay. I hope you understood. If you didn't understand, watch the video again and please go through your chapter in the 18 number chapter in the textbook. You can see page number 89 and 90. Okay, everything is given in the textbook. Try to read and try to understand. Okay, bye.